pile one. Who we got to pick? Oh my god, skill defaults to rookie? Let's go. Default, remember. Default difficulty. Excel assist, break assist? It's all default on, so I'm just gonna leave it. All this stuff is set to off. Okay. I guess that was it. Should I do qualifiers? Should I just do Grand Prix? I don't know. I don't know how this works. I have no clue. That's one thing that racing games will mess with me is all the stats. Oh god, oh god. Alright. And this is always the worst part about starting a new racing game is getting used to the handling. Not a good start. All right, we're gonna assume that track setting means the recommended settings. Oh yeah, I forgot it has like brake assist and stuff on it. Yeah, okay. That was the issue. Yo, Sleepy Mouth, what's up, man? How's it going? stick around late enough, might end with Remix again. Yeesh, taking an exam? What exam? I'm assuming you mean 300 level. Unless you're like the most educated man on the planet in that subject. Oh, university doesn't 3,000. Okay. I was like, excuse me?
Williams is taking the lead.
All right, this might be tough. Oh my god, it went that way. Maybe I do have to crank up the steering. I'm sure there are parts where I can like strategically cut across the grass.
Magnuson just ahead. Verstappen's right behind you.
I don't think that was one of them.
Williams is out. 21 cars left.
Laps remaining, and I'm in 18th. Not looking good. Yeah, braking is like really intense. Oh, baby. There's so many cars here. Just roll it past somewhere. Except for that. No. I wanted to use them to stop my momentum. That was strategic.
Williams Marini's 2 seconds ahead. No, 2 seconds back.
That might be a place where I can cut a corner if I do it right.
Marini's 2 seconds ahead. No, it's right behind you.
Alright, let's see if I can get the top 10. Not like that. We get a mini map.
Last lap. That's your best lap so far.
All right, that turn definitely cut a corner. That's one where I've just been running into someone. This is rough.
Nakano's 2 seconds ahead.
Oh, goes that way. Fake out.
Marini's right behind you. Now dropped out of the race. Irvine has dropped out of the race.
All right, I need more people to drop out. Like 11 more people.
Nakano's 3 seconds ahead. Marini's 2 seconds back.
Oh yeah. That was a play. Yeesh. Yeesh. So how far into college are you, Sleepy? Can we retry? Let's retry. Also, yeah, winning from the back is kind of tough. I guess that's what you do the qualifiers for, so you don't start out in the back. All right, let's see what that does. So that was too much. All right, so this steering is much better now. I don't know what I sacrificed for it there. Alright, passed a few cars there.
Williams has dropped out of the lane.
People dropping out. already doing better than last time. Oh man, only one more semester? Hell yeah. That's awesome. Home stretch.
Marini's just ahead. Truly 2 seconds behind you.
What's your degree? Does it also have to do with geography / geology? You're changing the steering. That's huge. Geography, concentration, and GIS / remote sensing. All right, that's some stuff I don't know. Could have cut back more. Okay.
Ralph, 2 seconds ahead. Berger, 4 seconds back.
That's what I needed to do the other time. Just swing left a little bit.
Herbert, just ahead.
But I'm gonna do that. Really need a mini map. It can't be understated how helpful that is in racing games.
Last lap.
It tells you where to go. Oh, don't stop. Oh, I missed it. All right, well, botch that.
At least it's 3 seconds ahead. No, no.
Come on.
Elise is just ahead. Ralph's right behind you.
Where is it? Come on. Let's get some people to drop out. That turn has killed me basically every time. Oh, someone did drop out.
Irvine is out. 19 cars left.
All right, do I get points for sixth? How many rounds there are. Oh, this doesn't look fun at all. car. I guess this is why you do warm-ups and qualifiers.
Magnussen, just ahead.
Oh, you missed it. Yeah, the first F1 game I played, pole position,
it was
easy. This one, not so much. No, this is not 100%. It's mostly credits. But like some games. Like the golf game I just played last time, that gave you credits just for playing through the tournament. You didn't actually have to win. So like that one, it's kind of hard to call that beating, you know? So that one, I played until I beat it. But yeah, we are not 100%ing all these games. The other thing I'm doing is when I beat all these games, I'm beating them on the default difficulty. There have been two games that I did not beat on the default. I beat it on a harder difficulty, and those were GoldenEye and Duke Nukem. GoldenEye, that was my idea, because I knew like it would be a problem. Duke Nukem was chat. They were like, no, because the default was, like, really easy or something. They're like, no, do it on the next one. And then the game took me, like, freaking 11 hours to beat.
Larini's just ahead. Verstappen's right behind you.
So that was rough. Gaining places, people are dropping out. Yeah, this game's tough.
Katayama's 2 seconds ahead. Barini's right behind you.
Is that a cut through? Yeah, I might have to do like the qualifier races to like learn the course and everything. And to get a better position in the grid at the start.
closed zone. 19 cars left.
Couldn't catch him. Oh, well, say, I already played the first Mystical Ninja game, Sleepy. I already played the first one. Goemon's Great Adventure is going to be not for a while. But Mystical Ninja starring Goemon, that was like 20 games ago. Oh, crap. Yeah, what's the qualify? So, yeah, it is on YouTube. You can watch my playthrough. What the heck? Alright, so I guess I just botched that. I'm about to just start over again. Yeah, the music's good. The game itself is, like, pretty funny. Alright, so yeah, what if I, like, go through all these options? Throws you out there. All right, so we gotta find all the good shortcuts. We gotta figure out how to do that turn. Oh, see, there's one. Interesting. That's what we need. What's up? It's like doing weird stuff. I honestly don't remember much from Drummond's Great Adventure. It's been so long since I played that one. I like basically remember nothing. Like, I remembered Starring Goemon pretty well, but not Great Adventure. Alright. Let's try a qualifier. Oh, come on. No damage. Wasn't the worst. It's probably the best lap I've done. Oh my God, really, Josh? Rivers is gonna kill me. I can't catch a break. Yeah, I draft Connors. He's like really mediocre. And then he has this amazing game that gives me a win. And then gets hurt at the end of that game. The play that gave me the win puts him out for who knows how long. Yeah, I didn't want to draft him either, but I felt like I had to. I forget where I drafted, like the sixth spot or something. Didn't want to touch the Steelers. That's fair. They were kind of scary. With no more Bell and Brown.
second position now. That's a new course record.
A new course record? I felt like I just spent a minute and a half in the grass. I'll read what you wrote in a sec, Jared. Took him an 8 in crab case, didn't feel good. 6.
Second place.
I did not trust Chubb at all. Or the Cardinals. I don't know. It was like, it came down to, like, I trusted the Steelers more than I trusted Cleveland or Arizona. It's tough. Like, if you weren't in a position to draft, like, McCaffrey, I don't know. Yeah, those are definitely rough for running backs. Yeah, I wasn't too thrilled on David Johnson either, and a lot of it was because of last year. Oh, it's so much easier when you just start out in first. I guess that's the move. Do the qualifier.
I'm just 3 seconds behind you.
Also, qualifier allows you to learn the friggin' track.
Williams is 7 seconds back.
Yeah, you were drinking the Browns Kool-Aid. I was not. I just could not picture long-term Baker Mayfield success. he just seems like the kind of guy that'll like get you pumped up and it'll last for a while, and then he just runs out of it, you know? It's like Fitzpatrick. He gives you some good games and you go, oh yeah, maybe. And then he just goes back to being him. Just not quite complete.
Schumacher's 10 seconds behind you.
Actually, it was pretty beneficial to run into that. Ryan Leaf 2.0.
Two laps left. That's your best lap.
And yeah, you're right. On paper, the Browns look good. But paper sucks at football. So I imagine with the Grand Prix,
you
earn points for placing, and you just have to finish with the most points. So it means I don't have to win them all, or even close, probably. I'm sure it helps. I forget which racing game it was.
9 seconds back.
Oh crap! I thought it was something else. But there was one where. There was like this one track I kept having to replay that I was just garbage at and would get like last every time. So I had to win the other ones to make up for it.
Last lap. It's yours to win.
What I think he meant to say was, it's yours to lose. I'm not used to playing a racing game where you have to slow down that much, though. But like, it's definitely a part of the game. Like, you have to do it.
Schumacher's 4 seconds back.
People dropping out. Yeah, Jared, Josh told me Rivers already has 2 picks. Thursday night, man. I had to roll the dice, right? Like, it's either like team's gonna just pop off or they're gonna be trash. I lost that coin flip.
You've won it.
Yeah, we won. Alright, yeah, so we'll do practice.
Almost 4 laps to go.
Alright, so we got the long stretch. Put on that pepper. Mm-hmm. crashing into people in the warm up. So damage is something you can turn on or off in this game. I wonder how bad that is. Pretty sure that's the pits. Do all these turns and actually playing the game. It's hard. Yeah, so I feel like it was it's there. Okay, there's a wall. Freaking hairpin turns, man. Definitely not fun in this game. Oh, yeah. Well, see, there are other cars, but right now I'm doing practice runs so I can learn the course.
2 laps to go. You're in 22nd position now. That's your best lap.
But yeah, no music is pretty rough. I don't remember if Pole Position had music or not. It might have. I don't remember. Yeah, no music is definitely rough. You know what? Oh, for in-game music? I don't know. So, I haven't had any issues with Twitch, but YouTube, I ran into issues with my Star Wars Shadows of the Empire playthrough, because some of that stuff was getting flagged. But what usually happens is it gets flagged by a company that doesn't actually own it. I'm trying to think of the most recent example. I forget what it was, but some song got flagged, and it was by like some DJ who cited their remix. Like, it was just, you know, it was BS. So I appealed and said that the person making the claim doesn't have the rights to it, and the claim got rejected, so I was okay. So you can get those claims overturned, because most of the time, in my experience, they're actually bogus claims. Yeah, Tony Hawk will definitely get flagged. all I can see. I don't even know what these things mean. It's my pit lap, so it doesn't even count. Look how much you have to slow down. It's crazy. Ooh, that worked out pretty well. I'll take that. You also, you don't get the mini map outside of practice, which sucks. I feel like that should be a thing you get on rookie difficulty. They should give you a mini map. I could put on Song Request, which is pretty tempting. Actually, Josh, you want to look up what the heck this next game is that I'm gonna play? It's called Flying Dragon. I have no clue what kind of game it is. I wish it was like Double Dragon. N64 didn't do 2D beat-em-ups. But they did have Gauntlet.
You're in 21st position now. You've set a new art record.
I guess I am not running this race well. I didn't see my lap time. Yeesh. That last lap didn't feel that bad. But apparently it was terrible.
91st plate.
I don't want to start out in last. But it's looking like that's what's going to happen. Yeah. Music's up, but there's no music. Yeah, they're all like 2 seconds ahead. Damn. Couldn't get a good lap. Boost the blocking.
Marini's right behind you.
Where are they? These guys. Damn, I made up 0 ground that last night. Tough.
Katayama's 4 seconds ahead. Verstappen's right behind
you.
Nakano's 2 seconds ahead. Katayama's 2 seconds behind you.
Alright. Caught two places. Three, because someone dropped out. Why do I just refuse to make
Ralph dropped out of the lead.
Someone else dropped out. Alright, I needed just 15 people to drop out.
The camera's just ahead. Katayama's right behind you.
Yeesh, 14th. .433. Holy crap, that guy destroyed everybody. Say the standings are. That's like kind of important. Holy crap, the turns. Really hope I can skip some. Oh my god, alright, this is not... That might be. Where did that come from? It's a lot. Speed run of this, about to look this. Actually, let's see. Timer's still going. F1 World Grand Prix. Grand Prix. Rookie. 39 minutes. What the heck?
Yep. Rookie. We're doing rookie category. Okay. For real.
Grand. All right. So he goes Grand Prix. Stage one. Oh, he's Villanueva. Villanueva.
Australia actually went really well last time.
Alright, well, I won the first one, too.
Routing this category. Track. Much extra. We're taking full advantage of that and setting all the downforce and other settings to minimum. Which is fastest, but it's a little difficult to handle at some points.
What is his?
The goal of this race is not just to win, but to... Oh, you're good for the start there. The goal is not just to win, but to block the person who's going to be in first place until he's out of the top six, so that he doesn't score any points. And this is the only race that I have to do that on. Trying to get someone out of the top six in this game is actually really hard to do. The AI does not really cooperate very much.
Damn, this guy's good.
It's important that I catch up to the person in first place as quickly as possible.
Wait, what?
I'm starting to figure out the trick to not in this game. Is that
what stage is he on? Where did he do that? Argentina.
So the goal of this race is not just to win, but to. Oh, you have to start there. The goal is not just to win, but to block the person who's going to be in first place until he's out of the top six, so he doesn't score any points.
So yeah, you just slow down like crazy.
Trying to get someone out of the top six in this game is actually really hard to do. The AI does not really cooperate very much.
Damn.
Those turns really well. As quickly as possible.
That's the end of that long loopy turn. And he cuts across.
I think I'm trying to figure out the trick to not take damage there. I have to swing to the left at the last second. I hope this is a better start than I had last time. Ah. Also, the AI can just randomly slow down whenever it wants.
Yeah, I guess I just have to get good. Damn. Another pick? You gotta be kidding me, man. Gordon, of course Gordon ran for a touchdown. It's tough. Give me that golf game back.
17th position now. You've set a new lap record.
Everything's a new lap record. Six. Oh yeah. Let's go, Rivers. Blame that on Rivers too. He distracted me so much. He made that happen. I feel like I should have picked up the Nueva guy.
Position there.
I don't really understand how to improve there. Have to get better times. Okay, there's the standings. Yeah, everybody just passes me at the beginning anyway. Alright, these turns do get easier to make when there are cars. You can do stuff like that.
Larini's just ahead.
Larini! For a little bit. But see, now I have to actually race the course without using other cars to body block. Oh, come on. That sucked.
Ralph, straight behind you. Prince has dropped out of the lead.
At least that passes people. I'd be pretty screwed without that.
You're up with the leader.
Two more laps, though. I was lucky. Totally would have spun out with that little piece of pavement over there. It's crazy how much you have to slow down there. Top three would be nice.
That's your best lap so far. Barrichello was just ahead.
He's in first, though.
Schumacher's 4 seconds fast. Denise is out.
I totally botched that. I, like, forgot the turn was coming up. All right, third. Third's not bad.
You're on the podium.
On the podium. Get some points. San Marino. Let's see, what is this guy doing in San Marino?
Stop. Stop. That's good enough.
Does he play? Does he even race San Marino?
I can briefly check the race standings already. Skip it.
Nope. What's the next one he plays? Skips the next two. Three races. Go on after Montreal. Okay. When we get to Montreal, I'll look it up. I like the looks of this one. Big one, you gotta slow down for. Or go as fast as possible into the wall. Definitely going straight across there. Smoking. Probably slow down. That's a good corner to cut. That one I'll have to actually slow down for. Maybe like a weird little corner thing. Damn, Shell went all in on this one. We can pit stop. Oh, are you kidding me? He won that last one? Crap. More and more I'm starting to think I should have picked him. That's who he uses in the speedrun. Doesn't even have a picture. How badass can you be? Oh, dude, he's one. Why am I not picking this guy? Alright, I think as much as it sucks to start over, might be the answer here. Rivers with 5, Eckler with 4, killing it. Okay, that was the bad turn. Into the first shortcut. Whoops. Into the second shortcut. Felt rough. Oh yeah, not recorded. Damn pit laps. Come on. Wall bouncing is actually kind of good.
You got the ball!
Alright.
That's your best lap so far.
Yeah, I guess track set is like the recommended for the track. Yeesh. Yeah. I wish all the tracks were this easy.
Brenton, 3 seconds back.
Mess that up in practice rounds. Touchdown. I think I got a touchdown right. Hopefully it's Eckler. Shortcut. No.
Prince is 2 seconds ahead. Coulthard 5 seconds back.
Second
place. Only 2 laps to go. That's your best lap. Prince is just ahead. That's 6 seconds behind you.
All right, come on. Need my shortcuts.
Elise is out.
No. That was bad. Oh, man.
Irvine is out. Last lap. You can do it. That's your best lap so far.
All right, death turn. There we go.
Brendan's right behind you.
All right. Let's go.
You've won it.
Come on, Eck. All right, this one was tough. I sucked at this one. We'll see what I can do. Tinius, what's up? How's it going? All right, struggling my way through this game. Definitely not an easy one to just pick up and know. Bear Waker. So, someone did a mod of Banjo-Kazooie, and they created a new level. But that new level is from Wind Waker. It's like whatever the, it's like one of the zones from Wind Waker. I haven't played Wind Waker, so I don't like know exactly what it is. But if you, like, just YouTube Banjo-Kazooie Bear Waker, there's some videos. Banjo-Kazooie modding community has been doing a lot recently. Banjo-Kazooie, Mario 64, and Smash Brothers modding communities have all been doing a lot. can't really speak for other games. I haven't noticed. Well, GoldenEye is working on GoldenEye 25 right now. That's a whole other thing, though. That's not a mod. That's a remastering. It feels cheap calling it a remaster. They're like rebuilding the entire game, but.
You're now in 22nd place. That's your best lap so far.
It's still the same game. Just updated graphics and audio. Yeah, if you're a GoldenEye fan, definitely Google GoldenEye 25. I think the goal of these for that mod is to have it ready by the 25th anniversary. Well, Tommy, what's up? I feel like I haven't seen you in a while. Grant, I haven't seen most people in a while. August, September, October was not very good for my streaming. Just like last year. Getting any better at this stage. Like, I can't imagine hitting some of these turns much better than I am currently. But my time still sucks. Apparently.
You're in 22nd position now. That's your best lap.
Try it again. Quite the menu. Dude, this game's intense. I mean, that's like pretty, those are all like pretty typical options for like a racing sim, like a decent racing sim. Especially like an F1 game. So I wasn't surprised to see it. And it can definitely look overwhelming. Yeah, it like auto drives out of the pit, and then you just regain control once you leave the pit. So like if you're not paying attention, yeah, you just like go on your ass, like I did. This lap doesn't count though. Literally, the most realistic racing simulator ever. Yeah. Especially when you turn off pit stops and car damage. Because who wants to make pit stops? Right now I'm doing a qualifier, so I'm just like going for my fastest lap. And based on your fastest lap, it's how you're like seated. It's how you're positioned into the grid in the actual race, like to start. So if you have like a good qualifying lap, you don't have to start out in last. But I kind of suck at this course, so I can't imagine I'll get much. I also don't remember what places get earned points. Actually, I probably forget that. Alright, what place my 17th. I feel like that was the best I did last time. I feel like it's 17th. Midnight Club? What's Midnight Club? Oh, you're talking about racing games. Dude, my racing games are like Wave Race and Extreme G. I did play a couple racing games I like though. If you look at my dock, there's definitely a couple that I liked. Not San Francisco Rush, for sure. That one sucked. So there were a couple good ones. Top Gear Rally, I think. Multi-Racing Championship. There was one that I went back and played a bunch just to get the speedrun record. I don't remember which one that was.
Only four laps left. You're now in 17th place.
Yeah, you have a certain number of laps in the qualifier. I can't just like do this infinitely. But as soon as you get a position you're happy with, you can quit. So like on the first track, I got pole position in like my first lap. So I just peaced out. But another like benefit to doing these qualifier laps is learning the course. I don't do crap like that all the time. Yeah, it's still 17th, so I'm just gonna get out of here. I'm not getting any better. 110. Two seconds faster than me. Pole third. Be in the win. Okay, so top six gets points. Okay. Yo, Prox, what's up? Glad to finally catch another stream. Yeah, it's tough, man. Especially when my schedule is so whack. But I'm trying to be more consistent now. Doing like 2 to 4 days a week. Free world records. Hey, man, I had to work for that one I was referring to. I don't remember what it was. I had to work for it. Let's see. Chopper Attack, I worked for that one. Off-Road Challenge. That was the one. I played that one a bunch. It took me like 10 hours to beat it, and then I went back to do speedruns. So I don't want to hear it. But yes, a lot of my world records are quite free. Quite free. Oh, I just realized my timers are jacked up on the overlay. Why are you, no one says anything. Yeah. Everyone's just so used to like bad streams. There you go. Sorry, there are a lot of like little stream things that I'm always surprised when people don't notice them. When something's off by like one or two pixels, I'm like crap like that. It bothers me. That can happen sometimes if you're using OBS in like studio mode. So the screen you're looking at is smaller because they have put two there. So you can like miss things. Which is hard to see. Yeah, I'm just not even gonna bother. This one sucks. Argentina, I did okay, I think. Wait, can you run out of gas? Time to find out. All right, so the fuel light's on. Because pit stops are turned off. Yeah, I think I don't remember what game I was playing, but I did like almost a full run with my timer and that stuff like that. Those things help with turns.
you're in seventh position now.
Yeah, that's seventh, I think, is where I ended up last time. The economy has been going, man. What are you up to? This lap. That was a little rough.
You got the ball!
Yeah.
That's your best lap so far.
Oh, yeah. You loved this game, Funk Monker. You're gonna have to give me, like, some advice then. Cause I am not really, there's gotta be something I'm missing. Like, some magic secret to this game. Is the trick just to like hug those red and white things? Seems like it is.
Prince is just ahead. Tiny 2 seconds back.
This game's definitely harder than F1 pole position. Oh, you actually like that camera angle? First person? I hate those for racing games. I like to be able to see the whole course.
You've got the lead! 3 laps to go!
It makes so many things easier. And you can see more. Especially like if I'm going off-road for like shortcuts or something. And just learning the courses would help also. That's a big part of being good at racing games is knowing the course. And all these games I'm playing, like this is my first time playing them. So, like, yeah, like, I suck. Meanwhile, if you watch, like, my Mario Kart or Diddy Kong Racing or Wave Race or Extreme G, like, if you watch those playthroughs, I don't look as bad. It's like, I played this before. I know the courses. Most of them, anyway.
Only 2 laps left. That's your best lap so far.
Dude, Funkmucker, if you like this game a lot, there's like one guy on speedrun.com that seems like really into it that has all the records. You should try and beat him. That'd be cool if I got a viewer some world records. Like, oh, you're really good at this game? Yeah, you should record yourself. Yeah, if you just go to speedrun.com and just search this game, you'll see this one guy has all the records. He has all the records, I think, for all the game modes and all the difficulties. Oh, you follow speedrunner.com, nice. Yeah, check out the game. This guy had Brokus or something. His rookie Grand Prix record is like 30-something minutes. But obviously, like, he doesn't do every race. All he has to do is win the Grand Prix, so he skips a bunch of races. And the ones he plays, he wins. So you just need the most points.
Sunny, 2 seconds back. Note, 20 cars
left. Yeah. Two wins. That's huge. I think San Marino messed me up last time. Oh no, it didn't. I remember this one. Do you speedrun anything, Funk? Or do you just watch speedruns? So I guess I answered my question about the fuel. Oh, you don't speedrun anything? All right. What are the speedruns you like watching? I love that you can just put your fuel on empty with pit stops turned off. That's funny. Okay, so yeah, it seems like that really is the trick. Just riding those rails. The turns. They redirect you really well. Mario and Sonic speedruns. Nice. I like a good Sonic speedrun, but I don't like it when they're really glitchy. It's like, oh, you just do this and you skip half the level. Those, I don't know. It's just not as fun to watch for me. Definitely should just cut straight across there. pit lap. Yeah, see, like there I missed the rail. Okay. Yeah, all right. The rail is definitely the key. I just gotta learn how to use it better. I wasn't paying attention. I am gonna keep complaining about no mini map though. Ooh.
Just set a new lap record.
Second place. Hey, some of these you do have to sit. I like the just cut straight across the grass.
You got the pole!
You got the pole! Holy crap. Being destroyed, everybody. I'm just trying to save the environment, you know, down with fossil fuels. Get out of here. That's a tough one.
Prince is right behind you.
Oh, is he?
Burger's dropped out of the way.
Only three laps to go. Yeah, I forgot. You can change the number of laps. Like, if you wanted to, you could change it to 1. But I think the guy that does the speed run leaves it at 4.
Princeton, 4 seconds back.
Getting a little better. You never step foot in a shell? Oh, you mean like a one of the arcades? I'm trying to figure out what you mean by never step foot in a shell. I'm struggling. Oh, you mean the gas station. I thought you were like, shell was like some weird term for one of the arcade racing game like structures, but you mean the gas station. I get it now. Yeah, yeah. That is crazy. Back in like the late 2000s, like early 2010s, I mostly went to shell. So I had like a shell credit card, and that was before I knew any better and started using like a Delta card. But so I used to like always go to Shell. Everyone should drop out of the race. You're hopeless. I should take that turn, but I just don't. Oh, is this fun to watch?
Friends, it's 4 seconds back.
Wonder if that was faster. This guy's 4 seconds back. AM PM. Where do you live, Kami?
You can do it. That's a new course record. Prince is 7 seconds back.
Vegas. Okay. I'm sure we have very different establishments of many kinds. We used to have a the DFX, one of the good Smash player. He used to live out in Vegas. More like that. Although he's Canadian, so it's probably going whatever. Dude, 6 seconds. Good. Good wreck. I don't know how many races there are. I think there's a lot. Wow, it's that intense? I guess we'll see. Get out of the pit. Oh my god. I like couldn't even see. So we just have walls here. We're just gonna be hitting walls. Did you like this course, Funk Bunker? I like can't even tell what's going on. I drove into the pit area. Damn it. I have to do this crappy course again. What a course. I feel like I'm playing Pod Racer. Alright, so that is not a shortcut. Cannot cut through there. Now I know. Go for a real lap. Remember, everybody, Funkmonger said he loved this game. Imagine just doing this course without hitting a wall. That one spot has the little correct barrier. No, you're ruining my perfect lap. My incredible time trial.
You're in 22nd position now. That's your best lap so far.
He's like, dude, you're not beating anybody. Thank you. ridiculous. That was easily my best lap.
You're now in 20
yeah,
seconds
place.
That's a new course record.
Oh, man. 112? 115? All right. Oh, that was brutal. Top six in this. To get points.
Prince is taking the lead. Verstappen, 4 seconds ahead. Bastards. You blocked me. That was killer. Yeah, this is like scoring points here is doable, but not when I do that. Seconds ahead. Denise is 3 seconds behind you.
No, not again, no.
Mackinac's out. 15 cars left.
Get out of the way. All right, need to pass a couple more guys.
Last lap.
Is it Retro Fighter 64 reliable controller? It depends on what you want to do. Basically, all controllers, there's like two categories they all get separated into. Viable for high level competitive Smash and everything else. They are not great for competitive Smash. I don't think they're durable enough. Catch up enough. I might redo that one. Which one is the Retro Fighters? That's not that. Is that the Brawler? Or is it, it's not the Tribute, is it? Okay. Let's try and do it again. The Brawler, yeah, it's, I think people had an issue with durability, but for like a casual N64 player that likes that style of controller and joystick, it's probably pretty good. Another part of it that was a big turnoff for me was the button placement. Like, I don't know why they decided to make A and B like a mile away from the C buttons. Which again, not probably not an issue, not even like noticeable for a casual player.
First stop is 4 seconds ahead. Magnuson's right behind you.
Screw that course. We're in Spain now. Extra controllers for Star Fox. What a good game. Did I like pick practice by accident? I did. Thank you. doozy. Short course. Dirt around the edges. Brutal. Not like last course, just walls.
You're now in 14th place.
Alright.
That's a new course record.
We can do better. Use the rails. No. Aw. Thought maybe that little dirt road would be useful. It's not. Bummer. That gotta be better for 14.
You're now in 11th place.
11th, alright. Gotta take better lines, also. That one really needed to slow down.
Yeah. 11th place.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Get on the road. I get like one good lap.
You're in the left position now.
Probably the best I've done that so far. This time here is going to be the crap out of me. Recovery. Yes, this is the best lap so far.
You're in fourth position now.
Yeah.
You've set a new lap record.
I'll take that.
No!
Ah, man. Thank goodness for auto saves. How's Philip? Oh my god, you suck, Philip Rivers. Sucks so much. Bronies, get out of my way. Alright. Highland Rift Gamer. What's up, man? I know, it's my second stream in a week. It's crazy. It's like I'm going back to being a streamer. I even put out YouTube content today. Granted, it was a game I played like 3 months ago. Dude, the setting sun in the background here is actually messing me up. Yeah, so like the last game I beat besides the one this week was July 31st. In August, I had Super Smash Con and Shine that I was getting ready for, and I went on vacation. So that was kind of rough. And then in September is when we decided, like, we're going to move. So September, I actually had a couple trips to Maryland to look at houses and, like, sign a lease and stuff. And then October, you know, end of September, beginning of October is when we actually moved. And then I had to get settled and catch up on work, and then had another tournament at the beginning of October, and then we had, like, you know, death in the family, and then things finally calmed down and I started streaming again. Yeah, it was just a hectic, like, 2.5 months. This guy is playing me close. Gotta be careful.
Princess right behind you.
Get out of the dirt. Racing games are the hardest ones to play and talk to chat. Yo, that's my dream, Jared. That's my dream. Touchdown passes to Eckler. I'm gonna need like 3 more of those if I'm gonna compete with you this week. Oh no. Yes! Back boost! That was so clutch. That was so clutch. Get out of the dirt. The clutchest of back boosts. Let's go.
You've won it.
Rivers up to 14. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's probably going to happen. You're probably right, Jared. He gets receptions, right? At least I think he does. I might be thinking of someone else. Dump that fuel. Yeah, you've been busy too, Highland. That wasn't too bad. Once this weekend's over, life will calm down finally. Nice. You think you'll get back to streaming, Highland? Sorry, this is my pit lap. Doesn't count. Yeah, I noticed he only had 2 caches this game. I checked a bit ago. I was surprised. I did not realize he led the league in touchdown catches. I know last week he had a carry at the 2 and he didn't get in. So that was rough. He definitely lost some trust in that one. It's gonna be great to go back and rewatch this video and just listen to us talk about the Chargers. Oh, that's a freaking U-turn. Yeah. And 5 catches a game could be, like, borderline worthless, or it could be really good. Yeah, I remember that.
You're now in 22nd play. That's your best lap.
Not your best lap. Thanks, buddy. This guy, commentator of the year. That is an absurd U-turn. It's slowed down so much to make that. I thought I'd be able to like spin out and do it, but no. Yeah, that 4-point game is kind of brutal. I forgot to look and see why.
You're now in 17th place.
Like, why he had a 4-point game. That's it. Uh-oh, my phone just went off. Is that another touchdown? Please. Actually, that was probably the touchdown from there. It was probably a delayed alert. His Yahoo is delayed as hell. Maybe you, Tim. Game's almost over, isn't it? Yeah. That looks absurd.
You got the ball! That's a new course record!
28 total yards and no touchdown. That's rough. This is definitely going to take me longer than the next hour, but I might just keep playing. We'll just beat it tonight. Get away from me, nerds. How did no one catch me? That suck. Oh, I can't wait to get have enough of a lead where I can just quit the rest of the races. That is one feature of racing games that it drives me a little bit nuts when they don't have it. When they don't let you just retire from the race. Like in like a Grand Prix style thing where you're earning points. Just let me not race.
Almost 3 laps to go.
I forgot to look up how many races there are. It's in the instruction book.
6 seconds behind you.
Say they're 6 seconds behind me.
Six seconds.
Be a way to just cut through that. I just don't care enough because I don't need it.
Prince is 4 seconds back.
Oh, now he's only 4 seconds back. Uh-oh.
Prince is 5 seconds behind
you. Yeah. Is the game over yet, Jared? Yeah, that was probably better, cutting through like that. Same with that.
Prince is 6 seconds behind you.
This is definitely my fastest lap. Stupid U-turn. Such a long straightaway. Raiders need a touchdown. Raiders have the ball. Josh Jacobs 20-yard touchdown. Holy crap. All right, Rivers to Eckler. 80-yard touchdown. I like the looks of this course. It just looks like a bunch of straightaways with really sharp turns.
They missed the PAT.
So now they're only up by two. Yep. Straightaways and hairpins. Bridgestone up in here. Oh, did I? I don't want to pit stop. Oh, no. That was the pit stop. Damn it. I didn't know. Shut up, Sleepy. Went so out of my way. Yeah, that's all right. So that one is like the brutal U-turn, that first one. The rest of them aren't as bad. And they have weird little things in between them. Getting distracted looking for shortcuts. It's not looking good. All right, we got this. Glad to see you're still here, Sleepy. How's it going? I'll read it in a sec. Oh, nice.
You got the ball! That's a new course record!
Remix or vanilla? Just vanilla. No, Mad Monster Mansion doubles. That's the future.
Ralph, take the lead.
On the freaking pavement. Does Mansion lag bad on console?
Ralph, just ahead. Elise is right behind you.
Like, obviously it felt fine when we were playing, but that ain't console.
Ralph, 3 seconds behind you.
Deku tree. Yeah, Deku has like always lag, right? It always felt off. Had to check.
Ralph's right behind you.
Yeah, freaking crushed him on that turn.
Ralph, 2 seconds back.
Stupid time up here. That was just a dumb time.
Last lap. That's your best lap so far.
There's a lot of turning in this course. You can't. It plays at Ocarina frame rate. So I've actually never played more than like an hour of Ocarina of Time. Nah, actually I probably played a couple hours.
Ralph, 4 seconds back.
But it's like playthrough number one, kind of like 2 hours. Where like you don't actually get that much done because you don't know where anything is, so you're learning. Trying to see when Ocarina is, Jared. It's gonna be a while.
Last lap. It's yours to win. That's your best lap.
No, get out of there. What the hell? I just refuse to get out of the dirt.
Ralph, 2 seconds ahead.
No.
At least he's 2 seconds fast. 2 seconds ahead. Elise is 4 seconds back.
I don't want to lose or not get first. Yeah, get bullied. Oh my God. No, Rivers did not. No! Really? Rivers threw a freaking pick? Come on. Alright, Tony. Damn it. 13. Should have gone with Tannehill. I would have gone Jameis, but Josh used a waiver pick on him. And then, yeah, it was between like Rivers and Tannehill. Have you ever seen like a better pick? Because why would you ever bet on Tannehill? But what are you gonna do? This course looks obnoxious. All right. Give me that steering. Get rid of that fuel. I'm guessing that was a skip I just did. That could be a good one. Mini Matt. I want a Mini Matt. To not hit that wall, then this might be working.
You're in 12th position now. just set a new lap record.
A new lap record. Burning up the track. Yep, I guess it's. I guess that's the way to do it. Give me that steering. This is an easy course to drive. I like this one. Definitely add this game to the to my list of random games I just challenge people to. Just because, like, no one could possibly be good at this the first time they pick it up. Seem that bad, but probably wasn't good.
Two laps left. You've set a new lap record.
Record. Such a long straightaway. Followed by not a crazy turn. Those soft, slick tires can't handle the fast.
It's yours to win. You've set a new lap record.
Another new lap record? Yeah, someone in chat, do me a favor. I don't care who it is. It could be all of you. My next game is Flying Dragon or Flying Dragons. What is that game? What kind of game is it? Oh, it's a fighter? Okay. Interesting. .104. All right, so that's round 9. How many rounds are there? Let's consult the manual. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 17! All right, if I just win one more. Then I'll be uncatchable. That's good to know. Wow, what a boring track, except for one section. Come on, Germany. Stay the same, like the steering stays the same. I don't know how to explain it. The right still moves you right, so that's good. What a dumb little thing. Speed for this track. Has those two little janky sections and then the one turn section. I think that's it. Nope. Oh. And all these sponsors. Jank number two. We won't count that one. No! Oh my god. Get destroyed, everybody. Yeah, in like the full version of the game, you have to also have to deal with weather conditions. So you have to like adjust your car based on weather. Which is really just the tires. But it is just another thing you have to worry about. So you can also set it so that it recreates exactly like the conditions and the driver times from the 97 Grand Prix. So there's that. Yo, Sleepy, are you ready for the King of Fighters stage for Remix? If only they were able to make walls that like break at a certain percent. Like the ultimate level. Because that's a kind of a cool concept. I like it. And in 64, obviously, that would make for like sweet combos and everything because of the walls. Did you say someone's 12 seconds back?
Almost three last left.
The platforms are so weird on that one. Which one? The King of Fighters stage? I thought there were no platforms. The new Terry stage.
Fisichella's 9 seconds behind you.
I didn't think there were platforms.
21 cars left.
Maybe I just saw someone playing it in FD mode. It's just like a fighting stage. It's just a flat ground, but the stage has walls. Like, you can't get killed off the sides unless you're at a certain percent. Like, it, basically, if you get hit hard enough into the wall, you'll go through it. Whether it's because you're really close and you get hit hard, or if it's, like, you're at high percent. I guess it's just based on your launch speed in Ultimate.
Fisichella's 14 seconds back.
Yeah, you don't want to murder anybody. It's like if Mike Tyson fought an infant.
Only 2 laps to go. Just set a new lap record.
No, not the Dragon King stage, which is awful. Oh, yeah. I don't really play Ultimate, but I watch so much of it because I upload all the videos. And yeah, so I follow Ultimate. I played it for like a few hours the other day, net play, and I like wanted to kill myself. It was so frustrating. The buffer system drives me nuts. Just because I'm not used to it. But then net play, like, I don't know. Yeah. Drive me crazy. But no, honestly, even if you're not that into Ultimate, you should watch the Terry presentation that Sakurai did. Dude did a 45-minute launch presentation for this new character, for Terry. Where he just, like, fanboys about fighting games. And he's like, I don't know, he's hilarious. He's great. Yeah, King of Fighters is cool. And Fatal Fury. I mean, like, Fatal Fury and Street Fighter 2 were sick. Yeah, fighting games were so good in that little short time period there. From, like, Street Fighter 2, was it, like, 91, 92? To, like, when Third Strike came out. Ah, man, fighting games are so good. Yeah, you should watch the Terry presentation from Sakurai. Even if you're not into Ultimate, it's just, I don't know, it's fun to watch and hear him talk about it. Like, dude just genuinely loves video games and wants everyone else to love them.
You've won it!
Oh, it's team. I was looking at team points, not driver points. All right, I technically have to keep playing. So if I win the next one, it'll be 90 to 30. I'll be, at least 5 wins ahead of someone. I can probably skip to the end. I'm probably done. Looks like a long course. I don't want to do it. See what Belgium looks like. Yeesh. Yeah, no thanks. Skipping Belgium. Accidentally did practice. Thank you. It's like my best start ever.
Ooh, 42.
All right, we can do this one. We can do this one. Sure. What do we got?
You got the ball! You set a new lap record!
Sweet. Easy peasy. Get out of here. Holy crap. 360. The best. Alright, now, this is probably my least favorite racing game so far. Not this game, but the one I'm about to mention. But it had the best crashes, which led to like some of the coolest moments I've had playing racing games. That was San Francisco Rush. Dude, this one, it was like flying through the air,
6 seconds behind you,
doing like backflips and crap, and just barely hit a checkpoint. I don't know, it was sick. Some cool moments for sure, but screw that game. Not a fan. Thank you.
Khalid is 6 seconds behind you.
So I think I'm actually going to stream tomorrow during the day.
Almost 8 laps to go.
I'm trying to take care of some stuff in the morning. Some work to finish up. Some guy down the street's getting rid of a CRT. Like a 24-incher. I don't have one anymore. I figured I'd pick one up in case people come over. Because no one wants to sit and huddle around with, like, 11-incher. Especially if I have, like, some co-op games coming up. I'm not about to play four-player Gauntlet Legends around this tiny TV.
Prince is 8 seconds back.
That was nice. Easy mode. Dude, so I was trying to, I played the golf game a bunch today, and I was trying to get one of the records for it. And I, like three different times I got within a few seconds.
Nope, dropped out of the race.
I couldn't get it. If I just played better, I could get it. Get more birdies. I was saying, if I just like play a good round of golf, I'll get it.
Prince is 9 seconds back.
9 seconds back. Oh yeah, another thing I really like about Smash Remix right now is that people are getting into adding new music to it. That's cool.
You can do it.
That's one of the cooler things about Smash Ultimate is how much music is in the game. Like, the Terry patch comes with 50 new tracks from SNK. Freaking ridiculous. Even Sakurai was like, this is kind of crazy, you know. It's probably worth more than the $5.99 for the fighter pass. 50 songs.
Prince is 9 seconds back.
A bunch of them are like remasters, but a lot of them aren't. Most of them aren't.
Seconds
back, get wrecked.
That's a new course record.
Hype. This is hype on the car. 90. So, catch me with 5 straight wins. Which is impossible. 17 horses. Alright, cool. I won. This game had me worried. I thought it was gonna be tough. Boom, 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 boom. This game also has like challenge mode and stuff. There's a lot of things going on. Nuremberg. Is it Nuremberg or Luxembourg? Let's see. Do I actually have to... Can I just retire now? I don't know. I'm scared. Oh, it's Luxembourg. Nuremberg doesn't make sense. All right. Japan. And then next is Europe. And that's it. Thank you, instruction book. Spin some tires. Round 17, this is it. Should I just do it? We'll see how it goes. Oh yeah, starting in the back. Course with all the people on it.
Nakano's just ahead. Katayama's right behind you.
Can't see over the hill. No, I'm not there. Oh my god, that was a huge shortcut. Is the game audio that loud? It's so awful for racing. Yeah, that's a good point. I'm about to be done, Jared. This is actually like the last this is the last track. I don't even have to do it. I could just stop. There. I won. Think. Yeah. World champion. Not all racing games have awful game audio, but this one definitely does. Now try professional mode. Oh, yeah, no remix tonight. Yay, credits. Even in rookie mode. See, like, this game has a lot of different not a lot of different, but it has a handful of different tracks, like music. It just doesn't play during the races. Huge misstep. I could have turned down the sound effects. That was an option. We'll let these credits roll. Update this spreadsheet. Would I recommend this game? Moving right along. Next game, Flying Dragon, and then Iggy Wrecking Balls. I played Iggy's Wrecking Balls for about 20 minutes so I could get good enough to beat Wookiee. That's my experience with Iggy's Wrecking Balls. Excitebike 64 has the worst audio. Okay. I wonder when I play that. That is game number 231. Man, that's down there. It's going to be a while. That might be a 2021 game. Credit's still going? They done? Alright, we did it.